Hello students. So myself, Mr. Siddheshwar B. Tuljapure, Associate Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So in this session, we are going to deal one topic from the section, it is fluid dynamics, and the name of the topic is Modified Bernoulli's Theorem. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to explain difference between the Bernoulli's theorem and modified Bernoulli's theorem. The contents are, the first one, it is the assumptions of the Bernoulli's theorem. Then we will go for Bernoulli's theorem. Then fulfillment of assumptions in real world situations. Then it is need of modifications to Bernoulli's theorem. Then lastly, it is the modified Bernoulli's theorem and references we are going to have. The first one, it is the assumptions of the Bernoulli's theorem. Just we are going to revise those assumptions as we have dealt this in the first section. The fluid should be ideal. We are knowing that the ideal fluids are the fluids which are having zero viscosity, that is, the fluid will not have any viscosity. So in case of this world, we are going to have a number of fluids are existing, and then all these fluids are having to some extent the viscosity. The viscosity of the fluids which are existing may be to some extent lesser or it will be more, but they are having the viscosity, because of which they are called as real fluids. And the, in case of the, say, ideal fluid, ideal conditions as these are not existing, so the fluid having zero viscosity, it is not existing at all. So in case of the fulfillment of this one, we are saying that the ideal conditions as these are not existing, so ideal fluid is not there. And in case if we want to perform the experiment, or you have to go for the, say, analysis by making use of the Bernoulli's theorem, etc. So in case of that one, so as the fluid is not ideal, we are going to come across some differences in this equation. So now, secondly, the flow should be, in case of the flow should be, the flow should be steady. And then the second one, it is flow should be incompressible. Then flow should be irrotational. Now let us see what happens to the steady, incompressible and irrotational type of the flows. It is now, in case of the flows which are existing in the real world, in some cases the flow might be steady. Steady flow refers to the, say, the constant parameters with reference to time at a point. It is now, suppose the flow is there at one particular point, if when we are fixing the pressure gauges, etc., where we are measuring the pressure, and then we are measuring the pressure now and after some time, so number of times, when as the time passes, we are going to measure the pressure many times, and even though the time is different, the pressure is remaining constant. Similar to that one, at a point, if the velocity is remaining constant, discharge is remaining constant, so like this, number of parameters, if they are having the constant values at a point with reference to time, we are going to call this type of the flow as steady flow. So steady flow can exist, and this condition, even in case of the practicals, etc., it can be satisfied. The second one, it is the flow should be incompressible. In case of the liquids, we are going to have the liquids are incompressible. So the flow associated with the liquids, these are incompressible only. So next to that one, we are going to have the flow should be of irrotational type. In case when we are having the fluid particles traveling from one position to another position, if the fluid particles are rotating about their own axis or mass centers, so these are called as rotational flows. If they are not rotating, these fluid particles are not rotating about their mass centers or axis, we are going to call that type of the flow as irrotational flow. To some extent, the flow may be irrotational, and to some extent, the flow may be rotational. So it is not perfectly possible for us to go for the irrotational type of the flow. So the Bernoulli's equation also we will see. So if the above conditions or the assumptions, these are satisfied, so in case of that one, the Bernoulli's theorem can be represented in the form of the equation as, so it is P by rho g plus v square by 2g plus z is equal to constant. We are knowing that this p by rho g, it is the pressure head, v square by 2g, it is the kinetic head, and the last parameter, that is z, it is nothing but it is the potential head or the datum head. The summation of these three, it remains constant. Now, when we are, say, going for the assumptions, how many assumptions we have satisfied and how many are remaining? So the first one, that is the fluid should be ideal, so it is not satisfied. It cannot be satisfied any time. The flow may be steady, so it is in our hand, we can go for the steady flows. Then it is incompressible, we can go for the liquids. And then lastly, the flow, it is irrotational, it is not satisfied. Now think of the fluid flow through a pipe which is having the different diameters at different sections. It is now the section number 1, say at that section we are having the larger diameter, then it continues for some time, then the further we are going to have the reduction in that diameter, but that reduction, it is sudden one. You can say that the sudden contraction of that pipe, it has occurred, and the diameter now, it is lesser than the diameter at the section 1 1, and now the fluid flow, it is occurring, and now we are having the fluid flow from the section 1 1 to the section 2 2. The lines, just you can observe, so that these lines, curved lines, these are indicating the fluid flow. And now you can observe, say after the sudden contraction, we are having some section where the diameter of that particular fluid flow, it has reduced. That CC, we have said, it is the vena contracta portion where the cross-section area, it will be smallest one, and then further it goes to the section 2-2 on the right-hand side, and the flow is from the left-hand side to the right-hand side. Now, in case of this one, you have to think now whether the total energy at section number 1 and section number 2, it is same. If it is same, then it is over, or if it is suppose not same, in case of that one, we might have the total energy at one of the sections greater than the total energy at the another section. So if the difference is there, the which one is larger, that is the total energy where it is more, at section 1 or section 2. See the answer of this one. Now the total energy at section number 1, it is more than the total energy at the section number 2. That is, the summation of the pressure head, kinetic head, and the datum head at the section number 1, it is more than the summation of the pressure head, datum head, and the kinetic head at the section number 2. Now we can have the explanation of this one. Now first assumption we can see. In case of the first assumption, the fluid, it was ideal. So the fluid flow, whichever we have shown now, how it is existing, and now all real fluids, they are having viscosity. So some energy will be lost when the fluid is flowing from section number 1 to section number 2. And in case of this one, the loss due to it will be the viscosity. So energy loss due to the viscosity, it is one of the reasons why the Bernoulli's theorem needs to be modified. In case of the second one, the energy loss due to the friction between the inner surface of the pipes and the liquids we can consider. Now when we are going for the losses, these are of two types. One, it is a major loss, and the second one, it is the minor loss. The major loss refers to the loss due to the, say, friction between the inner surface of the pipe and the liquid which is flowing. So this value, it is larger, so because of which it is called as a major loss. Now the second loss you can observe, so it is, say, the loss due to the, say, different reasons, like, say, the pipe, it is connected to the tank, then sudden expansion or sudden contraction has occurred. In the present case, you might observe that the sudden contraction, it has occurred, because of which we are going to have the energy loss. So this is minor loss. So other losses are also there, which are also minor, but they are due to the, say, fittings, etc., the walls, etc. So like this, the losses, these are coming into place when we are going for the real world situation, and these losses needs to be considered, and then the equation needs to be modified. Now the same equation, how it can be written when it is modified? So it is the at section 1 we are having this v1 by rho g plus v1 square by 2g plus z1 is equal to, and section 2 it is say p2 by rho g plus v2 square by 2g plus z2, and now on the right hand side we are going to add the head loss. It is, these are the references. Thank you.